So as per my teachings in salt, fat, acid, heat by Samin, I'm going to dry off these duck breasts, score them, and then season them with salt and pepper, leave them overnight in the fridge before cooking them tomorrow. So not critical, but I've started doing a wee bit more of the seasoning with the salt to help break down the meat and make it as succulent as possible. And then once you've cut that, so you can see right down, but you've not got into the flesh, just season that generously with some salt and some cracked black pepper. And then we're going to just leave that in the fridge to do its magic overnight. Next thing is the cauliflower puree. So we're going to take all the leaves off the cauliflower, just break it down into florets. Going to add it to salted cold water. It's a root veg, so we're going to cook it from cold. And then we're going to boil it until it's soft, because we're going to puree it up with some butter and cream and seasoning. Easy. And obviously add salt, salted like the sea. Boil it until soft. Next to blend up, I want you to get a blender for putting your cauliflower in. Once you've drained it off, just put that into the blender.
Cream, guys, cream.
And then to that, we're also going to add your melted butter. Now, bear in mind, depending on the size of your cauliflower, it's not going to be the exact size as mine. I've given you measurements for how much cream and butter I'm adding in. If you find that it's just not as loose as you need it to be, just add a little milk to loosen it up slightly to get the consistency we're looking for. So I'm going to blend. What I'm going to do is just put this into a pot, because we're going to leave it to one side to heat up when we're going to be serving. So I've not seasoned this yet, apart from the salted water that I cooked the cauliflower in. So what I do when I'll heat this up before serving, I'll taste it and season it as appropriate. So really, I'm not going to give you volumes again, it's just going to season to taste. And all I've done there is weigh out my grapes. I'm going to add 2 star anise to that. So the juices from this we're going to add in to make the jus for the duck a wee bit later as well. And also just give it a little spray with oil. So not too much, just a light spray. And we're going to stick it in an oven that's preheated to 200 degrees. And that's me taking the grapes out after 20 minutes at 200. And we're just going to leave that to cool for a wee bit. And then we're going to go on to cooking the duck. So the duck, I've taken that out of the fridge. I've just poured some of the extra juice that was sitting in there just down the sink. And what we want to do is bring it up to room temperature. So just leave it to sit out for about 30 minutes before we start cooking it. Once this has been sitting out 30 minutes, just when you get some kitchen roll and dab the top of the skins just to give it a wee dry off. And I'm going to cook mine in a cast iron. I'm going to heat this up, and once the pot has heated up, I'm going to add the oil to it before adding the duck. So I'm not adding the oil in, because then it gets to a smoking hot point that can easily burn the duck. So pan heated up first, add the oil, then the duck. Just in prep whilst this is heating up, I've also got my vinegar, because we're going to add that to deglaze the pan. And then I've also mixed my half chicken stock pot in my water and make sure that's all dissolved. So I've got this in a medium to high heat. Pan, it's heating up, and I'm just going to add the oil, and you'll see that'll dissipate very quickly because we've put it into a hot pan. You just want to spread that out. All we're going to do is add in your duck breast, skin side down, and start cooking that. And you'll see the fat start to render down. We're going to get a crispy skin, so we just don't want it to burn. Keep checking it. Probably keep this for about 3 to 5 minutes, depending on the size of your duck breast. We're going to be going on feel, all right? Because I don't know what size your duck breast is, so I can't tell you exact minutes. I'm going to be going for probably medium well on these duck breasts. This whole time, I just want you to be keeping an eye, controlling the heat, checking that it isn't burning. I just want it to go crispy, not burning. Looking good so far. That does that about 2 minutes. I'm at 4 minutes now. You can see that's looking good. I'm going to turn this over, turn the duck breast over, and then I'm going to check it. These are a wee bit smaller than normal. If you get bigger duck breasts, you'll see it go for about 5 minutes even. I've only hit about 1.5 minutes in this side, but I'm just going to check it. So, see, because they're only small, it's feeling like it might be done in another 30 seconds. Yeah, I'm going to take that off the heat and let it rest. So just onto a board and let your duck breast rest. Next, we're going to go on to making the sauce.
You'll have all this rendered fat in the pan. We're going to pour some of that out, but we do want to keep some of it. That's got some nice juicy duck flavour. All right, but I don't need all of it, so I'm going to pour a little bit out. Too fatty, but as you can see there, I've still got a little bit. At this point, we're going to add in your 2 teaspoons of vinegar.
And that is going to deglaze the pan. All right, so any nice flavour that we've got there, the vinegar is going to lift that up. To that, add in your stock. And then also to your stock, your roasted grapes and your star anise. And we're going to simmer that down until it reduces, and then we're also going to then remove the star anise. So that's not going to be in the final jus. Alright. Now I've increased the heat on that slightly, and we're just going to reduce it down until it's more of a thick jus rather than a watery, like just stock. Whilst that's reducing, the cauliflower puree from earlier, start heating that up and season to taste. If you want to use white pepper so you don't see the flecks of black through it, totally up to you. Either or is absolutely fine.
And last thing you're going to do, I've snapped the ends off the asparagus, put it in a pot with salt, and we're going to boil them for 2 to 3 minutes until tender.
And you know it's getting better when you do the zip test, so bring it down. It takes a wee while to close. So that's our jus. All right, we're going to take that off the heat and remove your star anise.
Once the asparagus is cooked, what I'm going to do is actually just cut each stalk in half.
Also, I want you to take your duck breast over and just cut that into slices or in half if that's what you want to do. And you see, just nice and blush pink. Perfect. Absolutely gorgeous. Then all we're going to do is plate up. So I'm going to get a plate, put some cauliflower puree, some broccoli, your duck on top, and then layer that up with some jus and some nice roasted grapes.
I stand in line until you think you have the time to spend an evening with me. And if we go someplace to dance, I know that there's a chance you won't be leaving with me.